Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. Web3, you might have heard this term before. Web3 is a new internet and it's literally changing everything, and it's also changing digital marketing, and it's influencing how things and products and services are being laid out and approached, and how customers are being approached in the digital marketing world, and how data is being provided and used and interchanged. We will dive deep into that in a minute, but first of all, this video is only for educational purposes, and let's get into this very interesting topic. So guys, let's start our very interesting topic here with the first reason why Web3 will make a huge influence on digital marketing. As you can see here, Web3 is built on blockchain technology, and that can potentially provide better data security and transparency versus the classic storage system. Of course, you know that the blockchain is one of the most secure systems on the internet. I mean, it's immutable. It cannot be penetrated. It cannot be hacked. There is no way around it. You cannot be hacked on the blockchain unless you have security issues with your wallet, not the blockchain itself. So Web3 is built on the blockchain, so it's very, very secure, and data cannot be jeopardized and cannot be accessed unless you have permission. And as you can see here, this will result for more security, not necessarily more data privacy, but it's just about the security of the data itself. And the Web3 lead at immersive technology platform provider Glimpse Group, and they can offer a scenario that both security and privacy are possible, and they can expect aspects of the Web3 to promote security and data privacy, and things can be moving into a very good phase here, into a very good direction, that it's more secure and the data are more controlled and in more of a good hand, and they're locked away from inappropriate use. So that's how the Web3 can be used to influence, or can actually influence, the digital marketing, because you know digital marketing of course needs data. So as we go here, you will find that the data privacy standards might be more stringent here. That means that on the other hand, the Web3 might also bring some more stricter rules and regulations from companies, from governments, from regulators, that data can be used, how data can be collected, how data can be used, and how data can be transferred or passed for marketing purposes. And this will have a huge and massive influence on the digital marketing world. You know that the issue with Facebook, and it was leaking, and Twitter, and how it was handled, and then Mr. Elon Musk bought it, and then some leaks came out, and European data, the EU GDP, GDPR, the regulation for the European Union, how they pass on data and how the cookies are used on certain websites. These are all in process right now, and Web3 will have an influence how things are moving, and it will also be impacted here, and the data standards will be tighter and it will be more strict, meaning that governments will need to ensure that their people are not being misused and the data is in well and secured places. So also expect that to have an impact here on digital marketing, and this will interchangeably have some influence on everything. So going here to that, the semantic web improves personalization. The marketing strategies here are already adjusting for the demise of third-party cookies. You know, cookies is a major key player here. Cookies meaning that your data is being accessed in a way or another, and it can be used for marketing purposes. All of us experience that. You find yourself talking about something, or you know, searching for something, and then an advertisement pops up in front of you. Can this happen with Web3? Well, that's a good debate over here, and this will be needed for digital marketers to personalize their content, of course. And the semantic web technologies enable users to create data storage stores on the web, build vocabularies, and write rules for handling the data. So handling the data here is a key factor. How to handle the data, how to pass on data, how to give access to data. So that's a very interesting topic that companies can target customers based on their online activities, interest, behavior, and this will be more personalized. And we already experiencing that nowadays. You think about something, you search for something, and it pops up in form of an ad in front of you. So things can be quite exciting here, how they are evolving in terms of data usage and data accessibility for marketers and marketees. And going now to a very interesting point, that the content freedom improves marketing reach. That's a very interesting point, because there is no limitation here. I mean, the sky's the limit. And this will improve the marketing reach, meaning that when it comes to social media platforms, is the content has enough reach. That's the one major kind of
topic or hot topic for social media platforms. The Web3 decentralization will have more freedom for content, meaning that, of course, it's a double-sword kind of thing. Some content might not be that appropriate, but in general, it will be more freedom. You can post almost anything, so it will give more access to more audience, meaning that that can also increase the reachability of marketing campaigns. So the decentralized platforms, this will be built on blockchain technology, meaning that things can allow for greater autonomy and autonomy and more control over the distribution of content. So there will be not controlled by a single entity or organization, that will be controlled by the whole entire blockchain and decentralized web. So generally speaking here, that's a very interesting topic and a very interesting critical point, that the freedom of posting and freedom of search and freedom of usage of Web3 and the cryptocurrency, the blockchain in general, that will allow for greater data to be gathered and greater data to be accessed and better marketing strategies and better marketing campaigns. So it's quite a sensitive topic or a sensitive way to approach things, but it would be quite interesting to see how things evolve in this aspect and how companies and data holders and data providers can pass on information and how can they better their marketing strategies using the freedom of content and how they can tackle this and how can they handle this. This will be very interesting to see in the near future.
So guys, in a nutshell, we talked about Web3 and its major influence in how data are accessed and used in the digital marketing world and how things are moving nowadays and how the data is processed and personalized and how you can use and benefit from the Web3 development in the next upcoming waves of the internet. So as I say, always inform yourself more, always seek more information, and as usual, everything is linked down below in the description. Give yourself some time to understand and absorb what's going on in the market. And as usual, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and leave any comment you might have in the comment section down below. And till next time, bye-bye.